Hello and welcome to Pink's Passion. Today's post is perfectly befitting our first YouTube video of the year, as I represent the refreshed setting of this corner with my newly done DIY frames. I have been wanting a dedicated wall for all my DIY frames, and finally I could take some creative freedom and make this wall a collage of all my DIY frames. Today I am sharing the making of 3 DIY frames which do not need any special knowledge or expertise, but the final results will thrill you. The very first one is already a shadow box frame, but I'm giving it a new look. I'm painting the frame brown and adding a brass accent here. I'm using a brass comb here, but you can use anything you have. I'm also giving it a base of a green fabric with some Banarasi fabric borders. I wanted the frame to match with my other existing frames in a collage, hence I decided to repaint the brown color. And because it's a shadow box, I had to paint the inside edges also. Once the frame is dry, you have to make sure to cut the exact size of the cloth and the borders to give it a neat look. Also, don't forget to iron your fabric before sticking it on a frame. I tried different combinations before deciding on the one I liked. If you do not have any brass accent, you can only use any kind of colorful fabric, maybe an ikit or brocade, or just about any fabric that speaks to your like. Since I'm using a shadow box, I did not give any extra support. But if you are using a regular frame, you may want to give some extra support behind the frame to hold up your brass weight. Using the Mod Podge, I glued the fabric on the frame. I also used no-sew fabric glue to attach the borders on the fabric. After smoothing out every corner, I gave the top coat of Mod Podge again. And once the top coat dries, we are already at the final stage of completing the frame. Any kind of synthetic rubber adhesive will do the magic of sticking this brass accent. However, I used V-Page construction glue from Lowe's, which holds 3 times stronger than the regular glue. Spread some generous amount of glue and hold the accent for a couple of minutes and you are done. The frame is now ready. I simply love how these DIY frames can bring instant color and a custom look in our decor. Moving towards the next one, it's a distressed wood frame. To make this rustic looking frame, I just gave some imperfection to a perfect looking wooden piece. I played around with some colors like black, white, red, and gave some touches of wood polish. In between, I also did some sand work to give it a rustic appearance. It was honestly my first attempt, but I enjoyed doing it every bit. As you can see here, all I did is color, sand, polish, and repeat. I kept on going until it started to look like rustic enough for me. So here is our finally done frame. I wanted to attach this brass nutcracker on it, but it was quite heavy. So instead of sticking it, I used a loophole of a nail. I simply used a nail to hang the piece and it worked out perfectly fine. My engineer husband came in handy when it was time to do some jugad in the hanging part. He used 2 nails and a piece of wire and made our own hanger. Brilliant, isn't it? And now we are moving towards our last frame of this video. This wooden piece here is actually a wall-mounted rack. I scored a deal with this one in a clearance at HomeSense Canada for under $5. It was actually missing 2 knobs, but which was perfectly fine for me. Just like our previous frame, I repeated the process of sanding, coloring, and polishing on this one also. And the missing knobs got replaced by this brass dias that I had handy. I personally believe frames like these are a great update to any room with a pocket-friendly budget. As I end this video, I'm truly hoping that the simple and high-impact ideas of these DIY frames will inspire you to make your own. By the way, the red and blue frames that you see here are also DIY frames. I'm leaving a blog post of making these frames in the description box below. Thank you for watching and circle back next week to see the styling of this entirely newly done corner. Until we meet again, toodles!